Okay, we finally got all of the pieces together to do the video that I wanted to do last week, which was the challenge between this unit, the Vortex Vanquish in 8x26, with its rival from Leupold, the Rogue in 8x25. Now, I am in no way an optics expert, but I've been using optics for both surveillance and law enforcement, as well as private sector, as well as for a hobby for many, many years now, going on to what seems like decades. And at 50-something years old, I can tell you I've got a pretty good idea of what I like and what I don't like as far as optics is concerned. My opinions are my own. You should come to your own opinions. However, I give you some data points to use in coming to where you want to spend your hard-earned money in the world of optics. Now, for eye candy today, we've got the tried and true. I love, love, love this unit. This is the Vortex Copperhead in 10 by 42, classic roof prism design, wearing a bino. Bino Bandit. I'll do a separate review on this. These Bino Bandits, let me tell you something, they make a world of difference. A world of difference. If you haven't used one of these things on your optics, you don't know what you're missing. Totally worth the $15 or $19 that you pay for that. Okay. Putting that down, we've got next to it the Steiner Night Hunter, tried and true, 8x56. This is a nighttime surveillance powerhouse, both for hunting as well as surveillance usage. But that is another review on another day. Right now, we're focusing in on these two, what I call, subcompact units. Vanquish versus Leupold's Rogue. Now, if you're used to the BK1 or BX1 from Leupold's, you were used to classic poroprism design, right? In fact, from Vortex as well, the lowest entry unit into the world of Vortex some years back was classic poroprism design. Both of these companies have gone to reverse poroprism design to make things much more compact, and they seem to have done that simultaneously, each with its own flavor. Let's start with what comes in the box of the Vanquish. Okay. We've got Vanquish 8x26 basic cardboard box. Let's see what it says together on the box so we have some idea of what we're getting. Fully multi-coated lens with anti-reflective coatings for brighter views. Nitrogen gas purging with O-ring seals delivers fog-proof and waterproof performance. Rugged diamond-checkered rubber armor provides a secure non-slip grip. And compact, lightweight design allows for extreme portability. That, I can absolutely attest, is true. This unit is extremely portable. That is a subcompact unit if I ever saw one. If we look, continue to look on the other side of this box, we've got our unconditional promise to you. Vortex will repair or replace defective or damaged products absolutely free, no matter the cause. unlimited, unconditional lifetime warranty. Vortex of Wisconsin. I've been so impressed with Vortex lately because of the value proposition. In my review of this copperhead, if you haven't seen that, why not just subscribe and give me some likes so I can get more popular than the two people seeing my videos? That would be nice of you guys. But this thing is an absolute beast when it comes to value proposition. Vortex as a company has been putting out sub-$100 units, which are impressive. And this Vortex Vanquish is certainly no exception to that rule. In the box comes a case, not one of those cases that you get with the copperhead, not the glass pack, okay? You get a basic Vortex case, which has a little clasp here. Let me just open this. Nicely padded. If your unit is in here and it falls out of your hand, I do not think it's going to break. But is it any comparison to the glass pack, which I showed you from the copperhead unit? Absolutely not. Not in the same league. Does not have a attachment for your chest at all. This is a basic belt loop that you would use to ring it around your belt, and the belt is probably, based on the spacing that's there, you're probably going to be able to do this with a 1 1/4, maybe 1 3/4 belt. The 1 3/4 belt may be a little bit tight on that. But we don't expect very much at an entry-level unit from Vortex. But let's see what else comes in the box. We get an eye cover. Atrocious. Hard plastic. Yeah. That piece right there has been sitting inside the box ever since I got it. It's useless. This cannot be attached at all to the strap. And therefore, you got to take it off, put it in your pocket, and you're going to be losing this from the get-go anyway, so it's totally not worth it. And that hard plastic, the life of this thing in the field is quite limited. There you go. But let's talk about the actual unit. And let's talk about specs. Size 4.7 by 4.4 inches. Weight 12.7 ounces. This thing is absolutely, utterly lightweight, portable, without a doubt. Eye relief, which is important to me, 15 millimeters. Close focus is 7 feet, 6 inches. You've got field of view, 6.7 degrees, 352 feet. We would expect a 350 plus field of view from an 8 by 26 unit, right? 8 magnification. We generally expect these numbers as far as field of view. So to me, there really is nothing spectacular about the field of view, which is on this particular unit. It's what I would expect from an 8 power unit. Absolutely portable. This thing fit into my jacket pocket with ease. You've got a hinge right in the middle, which makes it go into a compact mode as so. Comes apart like that for your interpupillary distance. The objective lens in the front are recessed. Not a lot, but it's recessed enough so you don't have to worry about putting this unit down on the table as such. In some units where the objective lens have very little space, you don't want to do that because if you have any gravel or anything else, not on a table like this indoors, but certainly out of doors, you may scratch the objective lens. But you've got a little bit of spacing here to save you from that. Armor coating all the way around. Very nice. I'm pushing down on the unit. It jumps right back at me. You've got beautiful stippling job, which was written on the box, right? Which provides you with a wonderful hold on this unit. And the shaping of this unit makes it so that you can actually get a very nice hold of the unit and have it comfortably resting inside the palm. And one-handed use of this Vanquish is really a breeze. I was using this at a football match at VMI recently, and this is the unit that I took down to the Biltmore for my vacation as well. For hiking purposes, putting it inside your jacket pocket or cargo pocket, this is really easy. The focus wheel tells us that it is the Vortex Vanquish. It further tells us we're dealing with an 8x26 unit as opposed to their 10x26 unit. Now, Bose, why did you choose 8x26? Because I generally like to use my units during early morning hours or late in the evening. And as you know, 8x26 is going to have more favorable nighttime low light visibility than 10x26. That's not always the case, but it certainly is within the same line of units, same quality of optics. You generally have greater low light visibility with 8 magnification as opposed to 10. On the body, I feel like this has quite a bit of traction even when where there is no stippling. This shape is absolutely lovely. Now, in that regard, let's look at the Leupolds. The Leupolds remind me of the Steiner units. It's got that same shape to it, right? It's a very nice shape. Also, fully, look at that. Look at that little contouring in the eyepiece area right in here. It's a lovely design. It really is. But notice something. The shape difference. In holding both of these in my hand, one-handed and two-handed, which one do you think was easier to hold on to and to hold in your palm? Now, let's go to what came in the box of this unit. I know, this is not in order, okay? You're getting this video free of charge. Please, just follow along. I have fun with these optics, and I hope that you share my enthusiasm. With the Leupolds, you get no better a eyepiece. Hard plastic. And like I said, no. But the case is a little better. Now, Leupold gave us a belt loop. With Velcro. Yep. Every animal is going to know something's up when they hear that noise. And if you're in a surveillance type environment, not so much. Okay? But here's the difference. Padding. Padding in the Vortex case, much more substantial than padding in the Leupold case, without a doubt. Size difference also. Your Vortex has more size to it than the Leupold's. Which one do I prefer? As far as case, putting the case aside, let's look at this unit. Armor coating, like I said, all the way around. Now, this is a 8x25 objective lens. Waterproof, field of view is 6.7 degrees. What was the field of view in the Vanquish? Degrees. Same. Let's just keep the specs right there. Let's look at the box. What did Leupold tell us we're getting in this box? We're getting a BX1 Rogue compact. We're getting a compact center focus Poro prism design. Magnification 8. Field of view 337 feet. Angular 6.4. Weight 12.7 ounces. I'm going to put it right next to one another. Let's look at the major issues. 8 magnification. 8 magnification. Field of view, 337 feet. ...352 feet for the Vanquish. 6.4 angular field of view. Angular field of view 6.7 on the Vanquish. You've got twilight factor, exit pupil, you've got eye relief. Exit pupil is important if you're looking for something in the way of a night viewer. You obviously will choose something with a 7.0 or greater, or at least a 6 millimeter or greater exit pupil. But eye relief on the Leupold, 15 millimeters. Eye relief on the Vanquish, 15 millimeters. So, the only significant difference between the specs, as I can see it, between these two units is with the field of view. Field of view on the Leupold, again, 337 feet. Field of view on the Vanquish, 352 feet. Greater field of view on the Vanquish. Now, let's continue on with what we have here. We've got 25mm objective lens as opposed to the objective lens on the Vortex, which was 26. We've got the same center hinge, allowing for a collapse. Let's put it side by side here. About the same size, I would say. Same footprint. Same footprint for these two subcompact units. But look at the stippling job on this Vortex. Not available on the Leupolds. Turning the unit around. That shape on the Leupolds is truly magnificent. But notice the little thumb indents available on your Leupolds. To the eye cups. Vortex. One indent. One detent, rather. Audible clicks on the base. Audible click at the top. Okay. On the Leupolds, same thing. Two position detent, all the way at the top and all the way at the bottom. Not much difference between the two as far as their eyepiece adjustability is concerned. Not that it makes much of a difference, but I can tell you that the Leupolds, as far as the keeping of the lens at the distance that you set, I think that you're going to have a little bit more play with the Vortex than you will with the Leupolds. Both are friction, but the pressure on the Leupolds to bring this down is a little bit more than on the Vanquish. Practically speaking, to me, that doesn't really make any difference because for me, I use only the base at all times. Since I wear spectacles, this is how I keep my unit, right? So to me, the adjustability of the eyepieces really doesn't make much of a difference to me. What does make a difference to me is eye relief. And like I said, both of these units, 15 millimeter eye relief on the Vortex as well as the Leupolds. So the only difference in specs that we are getting is between the Vortex being a wider field of view at the same magnification, 8x, than the Leupolds. And I presume that the reason for that is because this is an 8x25 unit, this is an 8x26 unit, right? And if we look at and review the weight distinction between this unit and this, we get the weight on the Leupolds coming in at 12.7 ounces. We get the weight of the Vanquish, also 12.7 ounces. However, based on the shape between this and this, I can tell you this. This one feels heavier to me. It feels heavier in the hand. I cannot explain to you why, other than it's the lack of the streamlining of the shape between this Rogue and this Vanquish. I like the streamlined shape of this unit. It fits better in my hand, and I have an easier time using one hand to manipulate the focus wheel on this Vortex Vanquish unit. I don't have as easy a time with this unit. Now, talking about the focus wheel of the Rogue versus the Vanquish, the Rogue focus wheel is armor coated, as is the entire body, right? However, it does not have the stippling job that's available to you on the Vanquish. That stippling job is actually very helpful when it comes to traction. There is absolutely no play in either of these units, but one unit is easier, in my view, to focus. And it's because of that stippling job on the Vanquish. We didn't talk about the straps, did we? Let's take a brief look at it. Basic strap on the Vanquish. Nothing to write home about. And absolutely no emblem on the Vanquish strap whatsoever. Leupold. Okay. We've got an emblem. Same quality of strap. Really nothing to write home about. But at least you've got an emblem. In use, let me tell you what I have observed. During daytime hours, I used both of these units. The unit that I preferred having in my hand was this one. I found it easier to hold on to, easier to focus, and I found that light was better, stray light was better handled by the Vortex Vanquish unit over the Leupolds. The color rendition also I found more contrast with the Vanquish than I did the Leupolds. Now, low light. I used both of these units during the nighttime. My observations were stray light was better controlled by the Vanquish unit than it was the Leupold unit. That was my personal observation. And I liked having the wider field of view, obviously, with the Vanquish than I did with the Leupolds. Now, there is a price difference currently between these two. Vanquish is selling on Amazon at $94. Leupolds are selling at $76, $20 difference. Is the $20 difference enough for a somewhat more constricted field of view and somewhat more stray light within the viewing of this unit versus this one? To me, no. I would prefer to stick with the Vortex unit because if I am looking for a subcompact unit, I would choose one that has the shape that I'm looking for, fits in my hand relatively well, is easy to focus, and gives me a sight picture which is somewhat decent and fairly wide. Now, is that bias on my part? Perhaps. I appreciate the work that Leupold has done with this unit. I appreciate the fact that they have a unit which is much better than what we could have gotten for $76 several years ago, for sure. But does it come to the same quality of the Vanquish? In my personal opinion, no, it does not. And if we put in the overall quality of what you get in the box in the way of cases, for my money, at the 8x26 or 8x25 magnification and objective lens size, for a subcompact unit, that one right there, without a doubt. Now, do either one of these units compare to this, the Copperhead Vortex unit, which comes in at less than $100, the same price point as the Vanquish? No, I would choose the Copperhead unit all day long, every day, but you're looking at a much bigger unit, much more weighty unit. It's the difference between your subcompacts and your compacts when we're talking about something else. I love this Vortex unit, the Copperhead unit. If you are looking at spending money at an entry-level Vortex unit, and you are not constrained by size and weight. You're willing to have 29 ounces as opposed to 12.7 ounces around your neck, and you don't want to stick the unit into your cargo pocket, which of these two units would I purchase for 90 somewhat dollars? Every day, all day. No doubt in my mind, right? But if you are constrained for size and weight, and you're looking for the 25, 26 millimeter objective lens with a magnification of 8, and you want an all-around unit which will not let you down, which one of these two would I choose? Like I said, the Vortex Vanquish. There you have it. That's my thoughts on the issue. Stay tuned, as I will be doing more videos. Hopefully, you guys are looking at the videos, gathering up my enthusiasm for optics, and you'll join me as I do other videos in the future. Can't wait for the video for this guy right here. My tried and true Steiner Night Hunter. Absolutely incredible optic. But, oh, that copperhead. Let me tell you, watch that video, and I think that you'll agree with me. Vortex is going off the charts as far as value propositions. Thanks for joining me, guys. Take care.